For a chemist like me, it's all very frustrating. Chemistry and creativity? No one wants to know.
Well, almost no one.
A nail that I buy at the store is related to a metal that I may find having gone through chemical changes that become rust.
I love chemistry because, on one level, on the level of chemical reactions, it is about transformation, about change. It's A going to B.
Within each area, physicist, chemist, painter, there are always some who have followed that, what I think is an ancient quest for knowledge.
Chemistry affects the way that I look at things. It enriches it. Sometimes some people criticize science with respect to, let's say, poetry. They say scientists shoot dead birds. What they mean is that knowledge of the innards of the working of a bird somehow takes away from the poetry of flight and of watching a bird in nature. I don't think so. I think it enriches it. Knowing how a bird homes in on where it lived, knowing the behavioral patterns, knowing the enzymes at work in a living organism doesn't take away from the poetic knowledge. My feeling for the bird, its freedom, its ability to soar, its metaphorical standing for something in human nature, the close connection for it, it just enriches it. And I, in fact, what I would like to do is I would like to teach the poet something about the flight of the bird, about the mechanics of the flight of the bird. It makes it much more interesting.
Tiger, tiger, burning bright in the forests of the night. What immortal hand or eye could frame thy fearful symmetry?
This is a copy of the first draft of William Blake's poem, The Tiger. It's exciting because you can actually see the poet at work. You can sense how he's struggling for the right word, replacing, improving, iterating, but most of all, creating something that didn't exist before. So what's this got to do with chemistry? Well, 50 years after Blake, we've got the work of a Russian chemist, Dmitri Ivanovich Mendeleev. This is the first ever draft of his periodic table. This is chemistry in the making. But it's a different sort of creation, identifying families of chemical elements that share similar properties. It even predicted the existence and the properties of elements that had yet to be discovered. Oh, it takes its time to get right, just like the tiger. In each of the crossings out, in the elements being moved from place to place, we see a living piece of work, an act of creation, a human mind at play.